से मिलते हैं, कंधे कदमों से कदम मिलते हैं, हम चलते हैं जब ऐसे तो दिल दुश्मन के हिलते हैं। अब तो हमें आगे बढ़ते हैं रहना, अब तो हमें साथी है बस इतना ही कहना।
अब जो भी हो शोला बन के पत्थर है पिघलाना,
अब जो भी हो बादल बन के पर्वत पर है छाना।
When you're on the high seas, there's something under the sea that you can't see.
As enemy shipping makes their way over the water, they don't realize that underneath the water lurks death. This is the story of the submarine arm of the Indian Navy, the silent deadly killers. And to take Mayur, myself and all of you right down into this magnificent beast of a fighting machine is Commander Vakil. Hi sir, how are you?
Fine, welcome on board. Now a word of caution, as we said, to enter inside the submarine, this being an operational platform, we got a lot of all the machineries in the operational state. So when you walk inside the submarine, make sure you don't touch any equipment, no machineries are to be touched, no walls are to be touched.
That means I can't get to try to drive the submarine.
No, you cannot.
I'm trying to get in, and about 15 feet down there is where I have to go. I don't think I'm going to be able to fit into this, but nothing ventured, nothing gained. Say best of luck, Mayur.
Best of luck, Mayur.
Submarines are made for guys who are a little leaner than I am.
This is a vertical ladder going straight down. If you're scared of heights or tight spaces, do not apply for a job on a submarine.
Wow, this is nice.
We were the captain of this submarine in a very important room. So thank you very much for having us.
My pleasure to have you on board.
Hi, welcome.
So what room is this?
We call this room as the control room, because this is actually the hub of all activities. It controls everything, right from my steering to my diving depth to my firing of weapons.
And that's it's the roomiest and the coolest place on the submarine.
This, as compared to the other compartments in the submarine, is a little more spacious, and I guess you can move that much more freely in this compartment.
So what is this thing that both Rocky and I are very casually leaning on? We've been told not to touch too many things and stuff, but what is this?
Well, this is what is known as the periscope.
Right.
This periscope has got a monocular vision.
Right.
You can see through the periscope.
Okay.
And what you can see from outside is the ships on the surface.
So when you're sailing on the high seas and you're close to the surface, somebody will be standing here with an eye on this at all times.
When we have the periscope up, there is an officer specifically designated for this, who will be on watch and who will be controlling the entire maneuver of the submarine.
So you can't ever be caught by surprise, because somebody is always keeping an eye out. But is that the role of a submarine? I mean, what does a submarine do? Is it a defensive role?
Well, you know, the submarine is actually a platform of offense.
Purely?
Yes, obviously. We are actually designed to just go undetected, attack our enemies and come back undetected.
So this is an extremely challenging job. I mean, it seems like a really hard job for anyone to do, staying in cramped conditions for weeks on end. You know, it's hot, the air is not changed for hours, you can't bathe. What are some of the attributes that you look for in your men?
You know, people do get claustrophobic, and submarine, I can tell you, is not a place for claustrophobic people. Submarine arm is a voluntary arm. Unless you volunteer for it, nobody would force you in. And I can only assure you, anybody who's got the sense of adventure in him only can volunteer for this arm.
So I mean, teamwork must be really important, because here you are with a whole set of people enclosed in a small area for long periods of time under a lot of pressure.
Teamwork is very, very important. When you are sailing, you wear something called the disposables. There is no rank in it, and that is why we are all one when we sail together.
So, if you want to make friends, a submarine is the best environment to possibly come to.
So, is this room always this bright and cool and comfortable?
No, I guess they've catered for your presence, and that's why the lighting is like this. I can just show you a glimpse of how we normally operate. Can we switch off all the lights, please?
Yes, sir.
Now you see us. Now you still see us a little bit.
We go down slowly.
You still see us just a little bit. And now you have no idea where this voice is coming from. And this is exactly what the inside looks like when Absolutely. You're going quiet and you're going to attack mode.
This is a really exciting environment when the lights are off. All the display panels are glowing in greens and oranges and reds. Quite thrilling to be here.
The main purpose of keeping the light off is to ensure that when we are watching from inside, we can see everything outside. Too much of light inside the submarine would mean that your vision is impaired. Every time we sail out, there are days together when none of the crew is either able to see the sun, and therefore day and night is purely by lights. Lights are on, which means it's day. You switch off the lights and it's night time for you.
Hello, we're back. We were always there.
If I had to stay out of the sun for 5, 7, 8, 10 days, I would go a little crazy.
He's like already a little crazy. It's got nothing to do with the sun, but it's a valid question. You said sun. You without the sun, you're without the clouds. Does it require any sort of changes to the diet? Because, you know, you're away
As
from it.
Our diets are surely a little special or a little different from what we normally have. It does cater for a lot of vitamins and other essential ingredients in the meal. But more importantly, we do regulate our style of eating. Most of our meals, though not exactly boiled, but are health conscious meals where there is not much of frying required.
I won't say this is a nice and open place, but it's the least restrictive sort of area on the submarine. Probably the most difficult place to be working.
Well, I've got two such places for you. We'll show you around.
A lot of the men have been saying the engine room is very, very hard.
Engine room is hard because of two reasons. One is naturally the heat is too much because of the engines running. It's almost deafening. And the second is the battery pit, where you actually cannot walk. In fact, you've got to lie down on a trolley and then work your business through.
Wow.
We've heard about the two really tight, restrictive areas. So how about we all go there and see if Rocky or I can fit into one of these
Absolutely.
Areas?
Absolutely, we'd love to see you there.
दिल में जगाते चलो जीत के गीत गाते चलो
No place in the submarine looks very comfortable to work at, but this, the engine room, has got to be one of the most enclosed, uncomfortable looking spaces that I have ever seen.
This looks more like a space station than a submarine. People are going in and out. There are guys walking around. The engine is about to be fired, and already this thing is so loud that you can hardly hear anything. Every possible inch of space is covered with valves and tubes. And now there are instructions being shouted past from one guy to the other. It's a lot of fun, isn't it? It's not just about firing those engines and getting out there. Remember, this is a war machine. So they not only have to get out there and go for a sail, they're actually fighting in battle conditions. And this is one of the hardest places that I've been in, even to stand. And there go the engines now! They're firing the engines!
Thank you.
this is one of the toughest place in the submarine, the battery pit. The heart of the submarine is the battery system, because the submarine's main regime of propulsion is through batteries.
Right. So when you're in deep water, you cannot run the engines, you will have to sustain on battery.
That's right. That's why these batteries play a more important role right. When we are dived underwater. All our propulsion, the power supply network in the submarine depends on this battery supply. The more we preserve them, the more we conserve them and use it judiciously, the more we can sustain underwater.
And when we came here, you made sure that we had no pens, no coins, nothing. Why is that?
That's right. Now, we've got a number of batteries which are connected, and these links are quite dangerous. They're high current carrying capacity.
Okay.
Nature. Now, if anything drops on these links, there's a tendency
circuit.
For a short circuit, and which may lead to battery fire, pit fire, or a battery pit explosion.
Sure. So this is one of those really dangerous areas. Huh?
That's
and
true.
He can barely turn on his side. I mean, he's lying flat.
Yeah, that's how he's required to work. He cannot roll in. He's not able to move inside. That's why it's a challenging environment.
So not all jobs that require you to lie on your back while you work are really easy and not dangerous at all. Yeah. Some of them can be actually quite dangerous.
Here's a game we'll play. Mayur, why don't you show us how to fit down there
right.
And I'll toss coins from here that you can catch with your teeth.
Lovely.
Let me give you some idea of how tight and enclosed spaces in the submarine are.
Torpedoes away!
Let me also share how important water conservation is on a submarine. The shower room is locked.
This is a really tight kitchen. And that's a yummy meal which I'm going to tuck into right now.
Everybody on a submarine is trained to eat a full meal in 10 or 12 minutes so they can be back to work immediately.
And that includes us. As you can tell, it's really cramped. And trying to get through here is very difficult. But where there's food, we will find our way.
On a submarine, it always makes sense to load your plate up, because if you want seconds, you got to do that whole journey all over again. Load up.
The dining area, however, is down below. So you have to come up here, get your food, and go down and start eating. You don't want to miss this. I'm sitting here in this really tight, confined space, sharing a meal with Suraj, Surendra, Mukesh and BB.
Amit and Rao.
Aap kahan se aap? Where are you from?
I'm UP Raibareli.
UP Raibareli.
Yes. Aap? I'm from Jharkhand, Ranchi.
Jharkhand.
I'm from Ahmednagar, Haryana.
Haryana.
Maharashtra, Ahmednagar.
Ahmednagar.
I'm from Uttarakhand.
I'm from Andhra Pradesh, Guntur district.
Where are we from?
India.
Good answer. So there's people from all over this great country of ours. It is a little collective unit of the essence of India, sitting here a little squeezed and enjoying our meal. This is a 22-year-old man who's volunteered for this job. This is one of the hardest jobs in the armed forces. Kabhi dar nahi lagta?
No, sir.
Huh?
Kabhi nahi.
Kabhi nahi.
Bilkul deep jaate hain?
Nahi, kabhi dar nahi lagta.
All these people, and maybe one or two more, can sleep in this little area that you see. There's 9 bunks in here. 9 people can sleep in this little area.
And the area is about 8 feet by about 5 or 6 feet across.
Ye sare jo bunks hain, there are as many bunks as there are people on duty.
Nahi, hot bunking system hota hai yahan pe. Yahan pe sare bunk full rehte hain.
Okay.
Jo log watch pe rehte hain unke bunk bhi full rehte hain. Agar unka wo watch se leave honge, wo log yahan pe aayenge.
Right.
Yahan se banda watch karne jayega.
Right.
Aur jo bunk khali hoga, us pe wo jo aaya hai watch se, wo so jayega. The hot bunking ka matlab bunk hamesha hot rahe.
They don't have enough space in a submarine, so they actually take turns sleeping. There's not as many bunks as there are people serving in a submarine. The people who are on active duty at various stations are awake and their beds are all full. When they're tired, it's their turn to sleep, they come back and somebody else gets off this bunk, goes off to do their job and they get into a nice warm bed.
Aapko kitne time ke liye sone ke liye milta hai ek jab duty pe hoti hai jab submarine
duty pe relieve hone ke baad 4 to 5 hours
beech mein gap milta hai 4 to 5 hours aapne ye jo uniform pehna hai ye uniform kis liye hai
ये
use and throw
use and throw
use and throw
suppose we are going for 45 days sailing हमें पानी नहीं मिलेगा
तो कितने दिन के लिए पहनेंगे इसको?
इसको हम 2 to 3 days में चेंज कर देते हैं।
उसके बाद फेंक देंगे आप। You'll wear something else. There's an acute shortage of water on a submarine anywhere. No matter how long you're on the submarine for, you cannot have a bath. So if you're on it for 45 days, you will not bathe for 45 days, which is extremely difficult to manage. So instead of washing or bathing, you get these special uniforms which are use and throw. And all these gentlemen are wearing it. They will wear these for 2 or 3 days at a go and then throw them away and put on new ones. These have certain chemicals to keep you fresh and hygienic. There's only one thing that I'm sure Mayur can do as well as them, which is not bathe for 45 days. We're at the bow of the submarine. Right in front are these, the torpedo tubes. And this is where massive torpedoes come out of to attack the enemy.
Because remember, submarine is an attack vehicle. And these torpedoes, some of them are almost as long as a bus, and come out of here, whack into the ships of the enemy and wreak huge amounts of havoc.
It says torpedo loaded right there. This is a fully operational submarine, as we told you before. Why don't you press that button, pull that lever, and we're ready to go.
Because the only shipping around right now is friendly shipping, and we're not going to do that. This though, besides being the business end for all the weaponry, is also very important because men can escape from this tube in case there are any emergencies.
In case you need to get out of the submarine when it's over 100 meters below the water, this is one of the suits that you need to wear, and here's how it's done. Avinder,
yeah.
Hello! We're complete novices at this, and we're not submariners, so we've got 3 people helping me here. When the chips are down, and in a real life situation, the need to escape, each submariner will have to do this all by himself.
Cooking?
I feel like the rubber ducky. The boots are loaded. This is not that much fun.
This is a dry suit. The next thing that's going to come on is a piece around the neck and then a helmet to keep him absolutely dry so he can come out at high pressures of water and zoom to the surface and be safe.
I'm a complete novice, so I have no idea why a dry suit is called a dry suit, because right now I'm already soaked.
You talk too much.
Hold your breath. Finally, I've got Mayur exactly where I want him. Hello, Mayur. Did you know you're fat?
I am.
Do you know you're fat?
Everything this man is saying.
So this is how that suit gets on. And he's looking rather good for a change. I think you should...
Sir, take this home out of it.
Half sit. Now what we're doing is we're emptying out all the air from the suit, so there's as little air in there as possible. And to make sure that he's going to be able to breathe, we're then going to put on those gas tanks lying down there. And here's the best part. Those gas tanks weigh about 15 kilos, but he doesn't know it yet. Are you breathing? Give us a thumbs up.
This is the bit where it starts getting super claustrophobic. I'm very, very wet inside this dry suit. I'm gonna let the professionals do it.
Take it off. Open him up, give him some air.
Wow, if you thought the sub was claustrophobic, this is even more so. It's all wet inside this dry suit. You have to breathe through your mouth. And then when all this is on, you want to climb in there and you have to crawl for more than 20 feet in water to escape.
Respect. All submariners, respect.
Well, it was wonderful having you on board.
Thanks, sir.
Before we leave, I would like to share with you a tradition that we have in the Submarine Arm. It's called Baptism at Sea. I would like to share with you a toast of the seawater that we've collected from the last deep dive that we carried out on the submarine. Please come and join me on this.
Sounds delicious. And to hand us this toast is L Steward Shafiq. Thank you. Cheers, sir.
Cheers to you. And wishing you also a lot of dives to come.
Thank you. Spectacular. It's been unusual, it's been rare, it's been splendid to be on board with the captain and all the crew members in this submarine.
We'd like to give a huge thanks to the captain, the officers and the men of the submarine for sharing their space with us, for sharing their food with us, and most importantly for keeping our borders under the sea safe so that you and I can sleep easy in our beds at night.
Thank you very much for having us here, sir.
Welcome once again.
A salute to the steel boat and the iron men. Jai Hind!